I'm blown away.
About what this show was what was going to happen tonight. Now you know. This is about the pole dance phenomena that's happening in the country right now. And man, I got some people with me tonight. As a matter of fact, I got the king of pole up in the house tonight. Man, Mr. Moses Carroll is up in here. How you doing, Moses?
I'm doing great. How you doing? That's the question.
Man, I'm doing great tonight. This is one exciting show, Moses. Man, I've been having buddies and people from everywhere just calling, wanting to know, why are you doing a pole dance show, you know? So we're going to have to explain that to them. I also got the lovely, and she's here to give us some wonderful credibility and tell us about the latest perspective of pole dancing. I have Miss LaTonya Sampson, the network butterfly of the ATL.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Welcome, guys. Wow. With the Man Cave feels honored tonight, you know. We do a lot of serious shows, politics, domestic violence, but health and exercise is an area that we got to get into. And tonight, we're going to be talking about this phenomena, this craze that's happening in the country. And right here in Atlanta, we got the king of pole.
Yes, I'm in the house. I am in the building.
Mr. Moses Carroll, yes. One of the first questions that came to us from social media, Moses, was, when did this gentleman club activity become the latest fitness craze and fitness alternative? Tell us about that,
well,
man.
Well, unfortunately, whoever asked that question, pole dance has been around a little bit longer than in gentlemen's club. There's a couple of countries. One is South Africa. And the other one is in India. They've been pole dancing now roughly about 50 to 75 years. Mm. They do it as a form of art. Some is an actual men's competition where they do it. So
men pole dance?
Yes. Professional pole dance gymnastic for men. Huh. The only difference is the pole is a little bit thicker. So it's about maybe 12 or 24 inches in diameter. Mm-hmm. And it goes about 15 feet in height.
Okay, okay.
And
well, you know, the bros need to be bigger, you know.
Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. If that's what you want to say.
Yeah.
But yeah, so, and the whole gentlemen's club thing, mm-hmm. Pole dancing has been a fitness fad right now for 15 years in this country.
Okay.
A lot of studios have popped up ever since 2009. I started competitions in 2010.
Okay.
So, fitness as far as pole has always been around. It's just been just a tight-knit group of people that's doing it.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Now, how did you take on this particular task of becoming the king? And I want to assume king of the pole. Now, do you pole dance yourself?
I dabble and play around with it.
Okay.
Because of the fact that it does help me with my upper body strength. I work out maybe once or twice a week.
Okay.
One day a week, I do some pole stuff. Like, I may climb it. Mm-hmm. I may try to hold myself in a flag position, which is just parallel to the floor.
Yeah.
I don't think it does. Just help me with my upper body strength.
Because it takes a lot of upper body strength.
It takes a lot of upper body strength, and the women at pole make me feel bad. Because they do stuff that I can't do.
Yeah.
So, and then you have the guys that already have natural strength and ability.
Yeah.
It's even worse.
Well, don't say that too loud now, because we might have to pull your bro card on that one now, bro. I mean.
Well, hey, now.
Did you see that intro?
I saw that intro.
But see, wait a minute now.
Now, I ain't going to say I can't do that.
But wait a minute. Wait a minute.
I ain't going to say I can, but I'm not going to say I can't. I'm just saying. You know.
It's a unique sport.
Right.
It's a unique fitness class. And it's challenging because, just like in gymnastics, some guys can do the pommel horse. Some of them can do the rings.
Right, right.
You have some guys that just walking around can't hold their own body weight up. So if you're running from the popo, you're running from a dog,
right, right,
whatever the case may be,
running from your lady,
may not have the upper body strength to get away,
right,
as fast as you need to get away. Whether you got to climb over something, pick something up, you never know. So, not saying that it's an all women's sport,
right?
But women do dominate it,
and I find that very interesting.
Very interesting.
Now, are you currently or up and coming? Or
no, I am not. She's going to take a class.
I've been training with Moses for some time, and I was jokingly, as we were watching the intro, I had to look over him and say, you just got me doing push-ups just here recently. So, to see, and much respect to the women that do pole dancing.
Yeah.
I mean, even much respect to the women who are in the gentlemen club arena. I mean, the acrobatics that are involved in the display and artistic fashion that they do it is quite impressive. So you can't take anything from them. The amount of strength, I don't know if I would take on too many of them. You know,
I tell you what, one of our followers I was speaking with earlier this morning made a statement as I was telling her about this particular show production. She was saying, yeah, I'm familiar with pole dancing classes, and she said that she had gone to one, and she tried it one time, and decided not to go back, that it just took a bit more than she thought she could, you know, manage. And address that, because I'm thinking there's going to be a lot of females that go to one class and attempt it and just kind of give up with the idea that that's just not something that they were born to do.
Okay. Well, being a personal trainer, being in the fitness industry now for about 22, 23 years, the only difference between a vertical pole dancing class and going to the gym and working out is what effort are you going to put into it in order to get to where you want to be.
Okay.
So if you want to have a six-pack, if you want to lose inches off your waistline, if you want to tighten up your butt, your legs, your arms, you have to put in some type of work and effort. Same thing goes for pole dancing. If you want to learn how to climb the pole, if you want to learn how to invert, if you want to learn how to just spin around and hold yourself in a pencil, unless you put in the effort, then you won't be successful.
Okay.
Now, the cool thing is, if you just want to learn how to dance, if you want to learn how to play around and entice your man or impress your girlfriends or hey, just get stronger, then you'll go and take class to get to that, and you'll stop right there because you're comfortable, you accomplish something. Mm-hmm. So everything is about accomplishment when you do anything fitness related.
And when she said one time, that was something I wanted to emphasize, mm-hmm. and I hope she's viewing tonight.
Yes,
please. I don't think one time is going to be sufficient to be a fair judge of, you know, whether or not you can do it.
I even have video of me when I first started competitions. Mm-hmm. I was touring the country, mm-hmm. going to different studios. The East studio I go to, they teach me a pole trick. Mm. And I will say, there's video footage out there of me doing it. Mm-hmm. It's very embarrassing. And I've been trying to find it so I can delete it. So if anybody sees it, send it to me, please. Because, you know, I fail a couple of times. Uh-huh. But that happens because it's just like riding a bike. So it's
intimidating. I must say.
And you were saying about the push-ups, right? Yeah, right. So
you don't realize how much body, mm-hmm. upper body strength you have or don't have, mm-hmm. until you have to hold yourself up. Mm-hmm. God forbid to be up on a pole and actually have to hold your whole body weight or try to do something acrobatic where you're mm-hmm. Holding up, I can't see doing a flex. Well, and you know, position, it's quite intimidating. And then you can take it to another level by talking about some of the things that you saw in the video or some of the things that some of these women do. You're already saying, well, could I do that? Is that something that I think I'm even mm-hmm. capable of doing? Am I capable of even being that sexy up there doing it? Mm-hmm. So it kind of puts certain walls in front of you before you even need to try it.
Well, I know Ms. Sampson here is very competitive, guys. And I've seen her sweating in Moses' class. And I just got a feeling that she's going to be a future pole champion.
Yes.
What do you
hold your breath.
It's going to happen.
That would be for private viewing, and that's that's what's exciting about it. If nothing else, I can't say I brought up this subject and not the majority of the women that surrounded me have said I want to, I have, mm. I'd like to, whatever the case may be. So I won't say I won't. Mm. I'm just saying you may not see it.
I understand. Okay. Now for all you guys that was asking me about this show. And I know y'all was wondering whether or not we were going to have a pole here.
I tried. He wouldn't let me.
He didn't try that hard. Believe me. I tell you what we're going to do. If my producer will put the tape on, we have some taping of one of his competitions elsewhere. And while we look at it, he's going to speak about it. And if we could get that on with the volume down. Okay, here
Let's
we go.
See.
Can you see that okay?
Yes, I can see that. Mm-hmm. Now, don't ask me who this is, because I don't remember the name.
You didn't get the number.
I got all the phone numbers and names in a database.
I'm going to have to pull his bro card.
But yeah,
you appreciate the beauty in what is happening here.
Oh, I do, absolutely.
Right. Well, just so everybody will know, this is the performance round of a competition that we did in 2011 in Columbus, South Carolina. Mm-hmm. Columbus has roughly two studios. Three studios. Mm-hmm. And any place I go, pole dancing is still looked upon as a strip club event. Mm. But the way the competition is set up, it's mm-hmm. set up more gymnastic than it is anything else. If you watch... it's like combining the parallel bars and floor exercise.
Okay.
Because you got two vertical bars, mm-hmm. and they're doing the same thing. They have requirements that they have to do. They have to do inverts. They have to do spins. They have to do counterclockwise spins. They have to do mm-hmm. left dominant holds. They have to do right dominant holds.
Okay.
And they're judged on all of this.
Okay.
Because most competitors, if they're right-handed, mm-hmm. everything they're going to do is going to be based with their right hand taking up doing most of the work.
Okay.
Our competition is built for people to get better. We force mm-hmm. them to get better mm-hmm. because we raise the elements and requirements for those elements at every competition.
Okay.
Which separates us from a lot of other events that are out there.
Now, let me ask this. How long have you guys been touring and doing these particular competitions?
We started in 2010.
Okay.
October 23rd, 2010 is my first competition in Atlanta.
Okay.
We went from Atlanta to Dallas, Texas, Charlotte, North Carolina, Columbia, South Carolina, and Virginia.
Okay.
And that was, well, it's kind of, if you're familiar with the DMV, Delaware, Maryland,
Virginia,
and Virginia, all that is all clustered into one. Competitions in the States have really been around since 2009. Mm-hmm. Mine's is the third oldest competition in the country.
Do you, when you travel from different states and hold the competitions, is it associated with some of the local colleges or universities?
No, not yet.
Okay.
The main reason why is because, again, you say pole dancing competition, you say pole fitness competition. Once they see video, first thing it's going to say is, oh, okay, so you're going to have a bunch of strippers in our building. No, we're not. Okay. Because most of our competitors, and what I mean most, if we have 50 competitors in one competition, 40 of them are either stay-at-home moms, business professionals, college students that take pole as a way to stay in shape, and they want to get better at doing this art.
Okay.
Because they take it really serious.
Okay.
And it's very challenging for them. So a lot of personal trainers, a lot of ex-gymnasts, they find this as a challenge for them because they're looking for the next best thing, especially in fitness.
Is there any certain regions of the country that seem to want to embrace this activity? And I almost said sport, and I got a feeling that it really is a sport.
Correct.
However, is it recognized yet as a sport in by, you know, the masses, if you will?
No.
Okay.
It has not gained the respect that a standard gymnastic event has.
Okay.
The stigma is still on top of it. But what we're trying to do, what Pole Dance America is trying to do, not really concerned about anybody else, but what we're trying to do is we developed a system to where it can be judged gymnastic-like.
Okay.
Because we do it, around with no music.
Okay.
The requirements that they have to do. They're being judged by three judges that are going to go over technique, flexibility, strength. They have time limits.
Okay.
Everything is on a strict judging platform, even with degree of difficulties, because there are some moves that are harder than others. So you need to be rewarded for that.
Okay.
Instead of somebody doing something like a pole climb and getting a three, when somebody else does an inverted pole climb, they should get a higher score because it's a more difficult move.
Okay.
So it's stuff like that that's separating what Pole Dance America is doing in order for companies to say, hey, this makes sense. We need to include this.
Okay.
Because there are some, you know, not saying we're completely behind the time, but there are some countries that are getting their kids ready to be pole stars because there's a movement to get it into the Olympics.
Okay.
Because of the fact that, again, it is a gymnastic event. It just has to be portrayed that way. So everything is based on perception. It's how you perceive it to be.
Okay.
So, you know, just like a good example, if I had a woman on my hat, the first thing they would say, oh, this is a stripper competition.
Yeah.
But see, it's left blank for a reason, because we're trying to get the attention of people saying pole dancing. And then they say, oh, and then when they find out we have men competing, they're like, oh. And then when they find out, you know, our youngest competitor last year was 14.
Okay.
Our special guest that's coming in this year is 13.
Okay.
So that makes a difference because you see parents are getting their kids involved in something that's, again, the next phase of fitness.
Okay. Ms. Betty, if you can come back to us, that would be great for now. Let it keep running up. Because one of the things we did notice is as we looked at this particular tape, it seemed like every time the young lady would change, it seemed like they would get better. In terms of their
skill levels, yes.
Skill levels, yeah.
The skill levels are always different because you're going to have amateurs and you're going to have professionals.
Okay.
The way we label that, if you are an instructor, you're a pro.
Okay.
If you are somebody that's taking pole as for fun in classes, then you're an amateur.
Okay.
That's how we categorize it right now. And that's kind of like the only way to do it because of the fact that there is no real level that you can say this person amateur, this person a pro.
Okay.
But what we've done for this year coming up for the Pole Dance America Championship is we have everyone in certain levels that they can only do the moves that they're required to do. So like a level one and a level two, a level three and a level four, level five and level six. That means the the moves get harder, the elements are raised.
Okay.
Because they can do more difficult moves. So if you fall within one of those levels, that's the level that you compete in, and that's how you win.
How is it determined, the level? Just what she shows you as she's competing?
I don't know. At every level, in order to go from level one to level two, let's say, for instance, there are 20 moves that you have to accomplish in a level one class.
Okay.
You need to be able to get all 20 before you go up to level two. Another 20 moves in level two, you got to get all those before you get to level three. So it's just like basic math, arithmetic, calculus, and whatever's after calculus.
Trig, algebra, and all that good stuff.
It's the same.
Matter of fact, you know, as you explain the levels here, I'm thinking that some of our female followers are saying, wow, that sounds very complicated to, you know, transgress up, you know, the ladder. Wow.
That's what I found myself when I started talking to him about this and got really involved or more interested in the championship coming up. I was intrigued. When you really start to examine the different movements they're doing, the accomplishment in doing all 20 moves to get to another level, you have to respect and take a totally different perspective of this as a sport.
Okay.
The categories, the artistry, the work that goes involved in accomplishment to get into another level, it just puts it in a whole. It's not just a display. There's true achievement in the activity. There's true pride in the display, not just even just for enjoyment.
Well, being a young mom with young kids, is being in this type of a activity, do you think that's acceptable to your children?
Absolutely. Okay. I mean, but it's about how do you perceive it?
Mm-hmm.
How do you present it? I mean, there's one way you could show that video and have a certain amount of music and look at it and be in a whole totally different zone than when you showed it with a song on it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So it's how do you present it? Mm-hmm. There's so many other activities that can be looked in one way or, you know, another. Yeah. Even swimming can be looked at in one way or another.
Yeah.
I mean, they're in a bikini or even something smaller. So that being said, how do you present it as a sport, as family day at the beach, or as...
Oh, family activity.
Pole dancing.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's right. Perception.
New millennium.
Because, I know this, the 2012 champion... who lives in Texas. Her husband, she has three boys. Their weekend activity, fun day, she has three poles in her house.
Wow.
And the kids play who can climb the fastest.
Okay.
And then the kids play, I bet you can't do this. There's no difference between having a pole in a park and having a pole in your house. Because when a kid see it, the first thing I'll say, "Whoo! I bet you I can climb that fast."
Yeah.
But you take two bros and put a pole right there. Man, I sure think that she can.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
I can think of a whole bunch of stuff.
Right.
So it's the mindset and how you look at it.
Speaking of which, is there a certain region of the country that you find embraces this activity more, especially as a sport, which you're, you know?
No.
No? Okay.
Because it has not hit mainstream America yet.
Okay.
When you see it in a movie, oh, that was awesome. Did you see her dancing? Or when you see it in a video?
I'm thinking it was in a movie years ago. Demi Moore?
Was
that the right one?
Well, Demi Moore did, when she did the movie that she did. Striptease.
Striptease, okay.
You had Jennifer Aniston that was just in the movie 2 years ago.
Okay.
And her and her fake husband and their fake kids had to drive from one part of the country to the other part of the country with some marijuana in the truck.
I remember the preview. I didn't see it.
Oh, you didn't see it? Great movie. Should have watched it.
Okay.
In order for them to get away, the guy, he said, my wife know how to dance. So she did a little striptease for him and there was a pole.
Okay.
So
anytime
it's done on television, in a movie, then you're going to get that. But when it was on The View, when it was on Good Morning America, when it was on The Doctors, it's a fitness activity.
Yes.
So it's how you want to sell it.
But when it's down in the hood.
But it's down the hood.
It's a strip pole.
It may be a pole.
Yeah.
Yeah. For stripping.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But speaking of which, do in your experience in these last, 15 years, you said, have you found that more white girls or black girls are more compelled by this particular activity?
I'm going to say it's 50-50.
Okay.
Most of the black competitors that we have, they do it because they want to challenge themselves and they want to succeed in it.
Okay.
And most of the white ones are the same exact thing. Well, some of them actually do it more for fun than anything else because it's their outlet. Because they go to the gym on a regular basis. Not saying that my black women don't work out, which you all do, but.
I thought one of the things that was very interesting about what Moses said to me one day was, you know, there are a lot of people who are doing this. You just don't know.
You have no clue.
You know, from every, like you said, from every profession, stay at home. You know, they're just, it's exciting, it's fun, and you're achieving the goals that you want to do in a fun way. So why not? So
there's a 76-year-old woman in Houston.
What's that?
That pole dances.
What? How old?
76.
Stop.
She did it for fun, yeah. It's a class. Then, hold on, and research it because I'm going to keep it real with you. There's a church in Houston, Texas.
What?
Every second Sunday, they have Pole for Jesus class. You bring in your, what is they called? The menu, the program for the day.
Yeah.
You bring that to the studio. Your class is free that day.
Okay. So they really are embracing it as a fitness activity.
It's a fitness activity.
Yeah. But even the girls, I mean, even at the gym, I believe you have some girls' night out activities. The girls just come there, and whether they're going to try it, great opportunity for them to just try it, or you know, sip a little bit, have a little fun, and get up on the pole. So
sip a little bit and then get on the pole.
Sip a little bit and get
just
up on the pole.
Just a little.
Yeah.
Because
what night is this?
There's plenty of opportunity to see.
I'm just saying, guys, y'all know y'all want to know too now. Don't even try. So I'm asking them why you're here, so don't come calling me. So
my suggestion would be to call us or come by the studio and buy your significant other a pole class.
Speaking of studio, tell us about your studio, name of it, location, how they can reach you.
It's Absolute Body Symmetry. We're located at 1 Baltimore Place, Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30308. My phone number is 504-975-0777.
Awesome.
We do personal training, whether it's one-on-one, two-on-one, or small groups. We do pole classes. We do abs classes. Anything that someone wants to do as far as their fitness goals are concerned, we help them on that system.
Okay.
One-on-one, two-on-one. And the main reason is because a lot of people don't like going to the gym. Or they want a trainer, but the trainers at their gym are not that friendly. Sometimes they're a little bit too rough. They don't take their time to get to know people. So we get to learn our clients and try to see exactly what you're trying to accomplish. We customize everything for you so that way you'll be successful.
Okay.
Because we want you to stay around long enough for you to learn what you need to do so you can maintain on your own.
Okay.
So that's the secret. That's what we do different. And we're pretty much all organic. We don't have push pin machines.
Okay.
We make you do all the work.
And you have a state of the art facility.
State of the art.
And it's also very secure.
It's past secure. We're like Fort Knox. Because you got to get through security to let you in on the property. Then you have to have an access code to get into the building.
Okay.
For 24 hours. And this is very important because we have a lot of people that want to work out 1, 2, or 3 o'clock in the morning. But certain gyms don't give you that safety feel when you walk through it.
Yeah.
Hours, you know, 24-hour camera monitoring. It's awesome. And then we're centrally located. So you can get to us from wherever you are in the city. So, ain't nothing like being downtown.
Great parking, too.
Oh, and the parking is great because our parking is extremely affordable. Extremely.
Yeah.
But you got to call me to find out.
There you go. Now, 1 Baltimore Place.
1 Baltimore Place.
Yes.
Northwest.
Northwest. Yeah.
ATL.
Right off of Spring Street.
Spring and West Peace Street, right where it connects. Right across the street from Emory Hospital, the emergency exit.
Yeah, and next week you're going to be having a very special event there. Tell us all about that.
Oh, this is my personal favorite. So, just so everybody know, there's a reason behind me organizing competitions and me getting to this point. Mm-hmm. When I first started, I decided I wanted to tour to promote polling as a way of promoting health and fitness, mm-hmm. because the name of my company is MC Healthcare, which is a nonprofit organization. We mm-hmm. put together health fairs, fitness seminars, and demonstrations.
Okay.
So when I took this project on, creating Pole Dance America, mm-hmm. I decided that, hey, let's make this a road show. Mm-hmm. Well, through the whole 4.5 years, I lived in my truck. Mm-hmm. I struggled with money. I had to make certain decisions. Am I going to eat or am I going to go to this competition? Mm-hmm. But I did it for a purpose and a reason. The main reason was is because I believe in pole dancing as an alternative way of working out. Uh-huh. It gets people motivated regardless of how old they are and what size they are. Uh-huh. So the Pole Dance America Championship is going to be April 11, 2015, at our facility. And it's our way to show the different levels of pole dancing, how it has elevated. Uh-huh. And give competitors an opportunity to just display how good they are. Uh-huh. And they can show off to their friends and family because that's the main thing they want to do. Uh-huh. Plus, the winner of each division will be competing in the World Championship of Performing Arts in 2016.
Okay.
So they have something they're shooting for because the World Championship brings people from all other countries.
Okay.
So it's a big deal for them. Uh-huh. And then on April the 12th, we're doing the world's largest chair dance performance.
Yeah, tell us about that. Chair dance performance.
All right, so.
This don't sound like a bro thing, but I don't know.
It is a bro thing. Because if a guy has ever been a dancer, whether it's hip-hop, ballet, jazz, tap, we've all done.
Ballet? Did you say ballet in the man cave?
Ballet.
Man, we're going to have to pull this bro card here. Ballet in the man cave?
Yes.
Kyle Baryshnikov is one of the sexiest.
Who?
What about
Tavion, the tap dancer.
He took ballet.
Well, tap dancing, that's a problem.
He took ballet.
It's part of the arts.
A lot of
football players.
Producer, can we get some more video?
Yeah. We about to pull his card up in here, man.
A lot of football players use ballet.
Man, football players don't ballet. Man, it's the man cave, man.
Lance Swan.
What? Who?
Lance Swan.
Ballet.
Lance Swan
was a bad man. That man caught some passes. And he didn't care who hit him.
Right.
Now, what you talking about a ballet up in the man cave?
To make him better at his sport.
How do you think he was able to get that vertical?
Man, let's look at these women.
What about T.O.?
We pulled T.O. bro card a long time ago.
We're looking at Ariel Sabrina. My goodness. Sabrina is a personal trainer and a marathon runner that lives in Greensboro, North Carolina. Mm-hmm. She won the 2011 North Carolina competition. Mm-hmm. She does pole, she does silks, she does lyra, and again, she runs marathons, and she's a personal trainer.
Now, this is another level of the pole dance abilities and skills here,
correct.
Is that correct? Okay.
And as you can tell, she's holding the pole with just her armpit.
Okay.
And the back of her thigh.
Okay. See, I know my bros out there really enjoying this here.
Right.
See, I told you guys we were going to bring it. Okay.
It's still available for Pole Dance America Championship.
Yes. So go on to poledanceamerica.org and buy your ticket.
Okay.
And for all those that are listening, Is she gonna
be Pole Dance America next week, bro?
No, her little twin sister is.
Her twin sister? All right, guys, y'all heard that. Right here in the man cave, her twin sister's gonna be there.
She has a twin sister that she doesn't know about. She's coming from Oakland, California.
Really?
Yeah, we got Oaktown,
that's my old stomping ground, Oaktown.
Wisconsin?
I don't know about Wisconsin now.
During the competitions, how many different cities do you go
to
the course of a year?
Last year, we did 13 states and 17 studios.
Okay.
This year coming up, we have 22 states and roughly about 26 studios that we're going to visit.
Name some of the states, because this is not just here in the Atlanta area.
We got California, Wisconsin, Rhode Island, Florida, North and South Carolina, Arizona, Indianapolis, Hawaii, and I'm missing one. Oh, in Missouri.
Okay. Wow, that's
the ones I can name off the top of my head that I know because they're three-peats.
Okay.
All these states have been in the system for 3 years now.
Okay.
So this is not just in any central location. Mm-hmm. It's not just in the South. I mean, we think of it, I think, a lot because of the whole gentleman club thing.
Yeah.
And that's part of the problem. We have to go so beyond that. I mean, all over, I mean, you said Missouri. Mm-hmm. There's just, when you look at it from a different perspective and appreciate the art, appreciate the athletics. I mean, look at her.
Oh, yeah. Look at her. Yes. Wow.
But, I mean, and granted, a man may not want to do that, but I don't think a lot of guys could do that.
Right.
Wait a minute now. Now you, okay.
The challenge is, if you get on the pole, Gary, I get on the pole.
What? Y'all heard it here, guys.
You heard it?
Right here live on Man Cave.
Yeah, right here.
The challenge has been done.
She said, if I get on a pole, she don't understand. I'm a Georgia Pine. We don't climb poles. Mm-hmm. We are poles.
Does any of that footage include any men? Mm-hmm. You got to appreciate it. And I've seen some video of some of the men that are doing it.
I'm mad at them, you know.
But I think
that
will help change the perspective. You have to. We have to show you some other displays that are going to help you change the perspective. And then I guess if you saw a male do it, you'd probably be sitting here appreciating the strength that it takes to get up there. So I think we get caught, or everybody gets. I'm not even going to just put on you. We all get caught in the sexiness of it and everything else. Mm-hmm. But when you can appreciate or see a man do it, maybe that will help change, or you'll view it from a different. Do some different eyes.
Nah.
Well, I have to throw this in here. Mm-hmm. Because when you go to the circus, when you go to see Cirque du Soleil,
there you go.
When you go to the Michael Jackson tour, and they have Chinese pole artists, even when you watched Ocean 11 and they were looking for a grease man, they went to the Chinese circus and got the dude that can climb up the pole, monkey climb, backflip, and go to another pole. Mm-hmm. You look at that and say, man, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. But when you put the word pole dancing in front of it,
right,
it becomes okay.
Yeah. Right.
Again,
you start thinking about tip money. Right.
So we end up going right back. It's the perspective of how you see it, but then the appreciation of it, because, and when you get a chance, guys out there and ladies, look up African pole dancer. There's a guy in Africa. The pole is about 20 feet in height. But it's not inserted in the ground. Mm-hmm. So he climbs up it, and he bounces up and down on the pole, and he's doing all types of pole tricks, putting his leg behind his head, and everybody's in the audience like, oh my God. Well, not the audience, because they're in dirt.
Right.
But they're trying to figure out, how is he doing this? Mm-hmm. But it's a form of entertainment.
Okay.
And that's the issue that we're having. Mm-hmm. And that's one reason I created Pole Dance America, is because I want to make mainstream America understand and respect that what these people are doing. Mm-hmm. It's just amazing.
Yeah, and I also want to say, at the end of the day, even though I'm using man cave attitudes here, you know, not caveman, man cave.
No, are you sure?
Yeah. At the end of the day, I want to assure you that if there's any kids out there, young men that's interested in this sport, interested in this level of physical fitness that it takes, because I understand the dexterity, the commitment that it really takes for a female or a male to do this. At the end of the day, if this is what you want to do, I support you. You know, I'm doing a lot of joking with Moses and Tanya, but if you really like this, hey, go for it. It's not a joking matter. Follow your heart. You know, I believe in people pursuing their passion. That's why I got this gentleman and this young lady here today, because they are both pursuing their passions. You know, and I commend you on that. I honor you for pursuing your goals and passions and everything that you're doing. And yeah, absolutely. You know, let's not get this thing twisted. You know, this man is doing his thing, and I really respect that. Next week, which annual
event or tournament will this be?
This is going to be year five. This is going to be the fifth Pole Dance America Championship. And this is the one that is our somewhat of a coming out party. Because like we've held the championship in other cities just to create more buzz about it.
Okay.
This year, we're releasing our, where we're shooting our pilot for the King of Pole reality show.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So this entire weekend is going to be focused on people getting ready to see what goes on behind the scenes, what the competitors have to go through as far as practice is concerned, and all the ins and outs of the pole industry.
Are there any diets that you got just recommended in this?
I don't believe in diets. What I believe in better eating habits. So
I know a lot of people like to hear that.
Right, because fad diets don't work. What ends up happening is, if you do something for a while, your body has to respond, so it's going to do what it needs to do to survive. But what ends up happening is that weight comes back. Sometimes it's twice as fast, sometimes it's three times as fast. If you create better eating habits, allow your body to do what it needs to do, as long as you're working out 2 to 3 times a week and getting pushed by somebody. My name is Moses, the King of Pole. Then you're able to
reach... And he does push you.
You're able to reach your goals and be good at it. And be successful, because you can make your body do whatever you want. I always use two examples when I talk to people about working out. Remember Angela Bassett before she did What Love's Got to Do with It?
Yeah.
And then when she did it, you was like, wow. Remember Will Smith did Ali?
Oh, yeah.
And then he turned around and did I Am Legend?
Yeah.
I was looking at him like, man, he beautiful. But you can make your body do whatever you want it to do, as long as you do what it needs to, what you're supposed to, and that's eat consistently, work out on a regular basis, and your body will transform.
Okay.
It doesn't happen overnight.
Okay.
So that's how it goes. So my question to you is, how often do you work out? See, I gotta put them on the spot, y'all.
Not often enough. I have to admit, not often enough. But I'm getting better.
Right.
I'm getting better. You know. Is that an invite to your gym?
Of course.
Because that's what it sounded like. It sounded like a complimentary invite to his gym. Isn't that what it sounded like,
he
guys?
Needs to be working out, because...
Wait a minute.
We all need to be working out.
He just said you need to be working out.
You need to work
out. I'm all right, man. I mean, I do, you know what I'm saying?
I'm okay, too.
Yeah, you know, I mean...
I want to walk around looking like Will Smith. I want to look like LL.
No, I ain't trying to look like the brother. You know, I'm good being Gary. You know, but I'd like to be a better Gary. You know,
Don't y'all want that six pack and them guns and them chesses?
We appreciate those.
Yeah, they appreciate that.
Right, yeah.
Hey, we do too. You know.
Oh, and that's why we us women stay in the gym or stay trying to find different creative ways to get our bodies better. So,
You
should be able to experiment.
See, I've cut back on sugar and bread, you know, and I know that's helping.
Right.
You know, but, yeah, you know, I'll do some more things.
As long as you're eating 3 meals and 2 or 3 snacks on a daily basis, you're doing good.
3 meals and 2 or 3 snacks is recommended?
That's standard.
Okay.
The reason why? Your body is programmed for that. You got kids?
No.
Okay. You know anybody with kids? This is my favorite example. When a child is born, when a child is conceived and is in the womb, the mother eats all day, every day, almost every 2 to 3 hours. So that child is taking in nourishment.
Okay.
Once the child is born, you ever notice, well, you don't know, but you ever notice that a child is going to eat every 2 to 3 hours. You're going to stick a bottle in that child's mouth. The child becomes programmed to taking food in. When the child turns 7, it still eats every 2 to 3 hours. When the child turns 12, 16. Once we hit 20, 21, and we out on our own or doing our own thing, it goes from 6 times a day to once or twice a day.
Yeah.
And you try to figure out, where did this weight gain come from? Because you slowed your metabolism down. Your body's not able to use the fuel, so it holds on to it. So that's why women expand, and guys end up getting a pot belly.
Okay.
It's because that's storage. That's fuel for your muscles.
Okay.
But when you work out on a regular basis
and burn that storage.
Right. Then you can control what your body does.
Okay.
if you're not working out and you're not eating consistently on a regular basis, your body is going to respond. So it's going to respond in a negative manner because it's trying to survive. So you have to eat. That's the fun part about working out. You get to eat. You can eat, pretty much eat whatever you want in moderation, but you get to eat.
One of the things when I did used to work out fairly regularly and go to the gym and lift weights, we would often use protein to increase the appetite.
Right.
You know, is that something that's still recommended?
Right. You still have to take in protein. You still have to take anywhere between 15 and 20 grams per meal. But if you're not working out on a consistent basis.
Yeah. And it don't have anywhere to go.
It doesn't have anywhere to go but out.
Yeah.
Or it's going to be stored. And you don't want to do that. Okay. So the best thing to do is, even if you do 50 push-ups and 100 jumping jacks every morning and every night, that's better than doing nothing at all. Yeah. If you're sitting watching TV, if you watch the Man Show right now, you could be doing jumping jacks and listening to us talk right now. Why? Mm-hmm. It's because you're keeping your body going.
Mm-hmm.
It builds your endurance up. And you, as being a man, to increase your stamina, you have to increase your blood flow. This keeps you off of Viagra. And I'm only going to say that one time.
Say that again. There's a few guys that watch us.
I'm going to say it one more time.
Mm-hmm.
The more you work out, the more you increase your cardiovascular and build your endurance stamina, it increases your blood flow, which means it keeps you off of Viagra.
Now, that's something, that's good information for the man cave right there. Yeah.
That's why I work out on a consistent basis, because I don't need complaints. They already got stuff to complain about.
Okay, guys, it's
We lost the information on the chair dance.
www.poledanceamerica.org. The chair dance information is on there. Get you a chair. We're going to give you a man cave discount because your man right here.
So
anybody mentions the man cave, you can get a discounted chair for anybody you want. It's $20. The regular price is $25, so we're going to knock $5 off for all the man chair, all the man cave guys. So you can come out and participate in this event because we are trying to raise 1 million pounds of food for the Atlanta Food Bank. And that's the,
awesome.
And that's the catch behind it.
Awesome.
This is going to be an annual event that we're going to do because, you know, people struggling with hunger is always going to be one of the things that we have to deal with in our country. But in Atlanta, it's very important because where we're located, you know, downtown, you have a lot of homeless shelters down there and those people, and they need food.
Yes, they do, especially around the holidays.
Right?
Yeah.
So we can do this every April.
One more time.
What's up?
Next week is going to be your...
April 11th, April 12th, the Pole Dance America Championship and the Guinness Book of World Record largest chair dance performance.
Location?
One Baltimore Place, Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30308 at the Absolute Body Symmetry, Baltimore Row Building.
Awesome, awesome. Anything you got going you need to talk about?
I'll be there.
Awesome.
Your Network Butterfly going to be in the house.
Network Butterfly. Hey, guys, we really appreciate you guys coming
Man,
tonight. It's
you.
Been
Thank
such
you.
An honor, okay?
It's been fun.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Man Cave.
Awesome. Man Cave TV show.
What's the hook? Do we have a hook?
Well, the Man Cave is a little out of shape tonight. Hey, we'll see you next time. Great show. Great show.
Yeah, he's doing this.